So if we start off with securing the conduit system, so in this case, it's been a black enamel conduit system here. I made this about 18 years ago when I first came into teaching. I'm going to leave it behind, but it illustrates the different styles of fixings for conduit, and under an old City and Guilds exam, it used to suggest why you would use each of the fixings here of these four. So we're going to still run through that. I still talk about that in my lessons previously and when I was teaching at Tresham College itself. So what we've got here then, I'll try and keep it in camera, so I'll try and keep it in shot. So what we've got here is from bottom to top, different fixings, and the fixings mean how close it is to the surface. In each case, obviously it's a piece of wood, but there is a reason why we would be using each of these. So we've got, in this case here, just a plain saddle. So it's just really effectively the front of a saddle. They're all saddles, but all different types. This is a plain saddle. And the thinking behind that, maybe move it around this way, thinking behind that was it kept it very close to the surface. And the exam question in the old days used to say, when would you use a plain saddle? A plain saddle would be used when you're on a smooth surface like wood. So that's a plain saddle there. So we move along to this one here. This one here is a traditional saddle. Here's a galvanized version of it. Okay, this one being black enamel. So that's a spacer bar saddle. You undo the two little screws on the front, those two screws, and the saddle front comes off. You secure the back of it, so you secure the back plate onto the actual surface and then tighten the two screws up when you drop it on, so we're using the workshop. So we've got a spacer bar saddle here. So what's the reason behind using a spacer bar saddle? It raises it slightly further off the surface. The reason behind that, according to an old exam question, was where you had irregular brickwork. In other words, a brick wall will never be perfectly smooth. To allow for irregularities in it, you'd use a spacer bar saddle. Moving along to the third one, this is now bridged it even further off the surface, so we're a little bit further off now. This is a distance saddle. Okay, so you can see that it's a lot higher off the actual surface itself, the distance saddle. The distance saddle would be used where the wall is damp, so it creates a larger gap here, meaning a film of water wouldn't sit in here. So in order to bridge it off a damp surface, the old exam questions used to say you would use a distance saddle. And the very last one here, he's got the biggest gap. You see, I clearly can get my finger under the conduit itself. And this saddle here is called a hospital saddle. It's slightly different in shape. It's certainly raised further up, and you'll be expected to identify these in exam by pictures and making sure you can see it sprays out at the ends here. They exaggerated on the actual exam question. This is a hospital saddle. So what's the thinking behind that? My students usually say, well, it's in a hospital. Well, that's not the case, because when I walk down the corridor to find the Costa coffee in a hospital, I don't see the conduits in the corridor secured using hospital saddles. But they are used in parts of hospitals. So areas of high hygiene, maybe in the medical theatre, maybe in the mortuary, maybe in the canteen areas, that you'd need a saddle that bridges it off fur enough in order to allow a cloth to go underneath in order to clean the conduit itself. I wouldn't recommend the conduit in a high hygiene area was this style of black enamel, but we would be the thinking behind it is that in order to bridge it off further, we would use a hospital saddle for areas of high hygiene, food manufacturing, etc. So there are four common fixings. So if we turn it around this way, we've got plain saddle, smooth surfaces, spacer bar saddle, irregular brickwork, distance saddle, where the wall or surface is damp, and then at the bottom, hospital saddle for areas of high hygiene. We'll also talk about the crampet. We'll talk about that one in the classroom as well and where we use that, as well as a girder clip. But the four common saddles are the ones I need us to remember in this part of the presentation. So let's put that back down. So for this whistle stop tour of conduit, and in this case, metal conduit, I hope this video has been some help.